Okay, well, some questions.
We got. Oh, yeah, we got email. Okay, let's get to it. All right, Mr. R says, if there is any kind of a financial issue in this country, would it be better to have money in a bank savings account or in a government securities type fund, a money market fund that would invest in government securities? Again, would one be better off just leaving money in a bank or instead investing in a mutual fund that has its assets in a basket of government securities?
You're overcomplicating the thing. I tell you the truth, if there's a financial crash, the place you want your money is in a bank, because they'll shut the banks down. They'll embargo your accounts, not give you access to your accounts. That's happened over and over again in financial crisis. And then they'll take a piece of it and give you a little piece back. I think money market, if you want that kind of security, I think money market funds that invest exclusively in U.S. government securities is probably, that's what you asked, that's the better way to go. I'm not giving you the broad panoply, I'm just talking about what you ask, and that's, to me, would be better. All right.
Okay. Sarah says, a dear friend asked me to marry him. He used to be married 2.5 years ago, but his wife left him. Although he is against divorce, it was out of his control. I'm a Christian, and he is too. But is it acceptable for us to marry? Should I accept his proposal?
I read extensively today in 1 Corinthians where the Apostle Paul goes into great length about the relationship of married people to one another, single people to one another, how you ought to do, what sex is all about kind of thing. It was very extensive. And his conclusion is that if an unbeliever is going to live with you, then don't divorce them. But if the unbeliever leaves you, the believer is not bound in that case, and that's called the Pauline privilege. So I think in your case, the unbeliever left, and you're not bound. And so if you found you should get married in the Lord, you find somebody who knows the Lord, then that's perfectly acceptable. You don't have to feel guilty about it. All right?
Good advice. All right. Jerry writes in, Pat, I believe in the Trinity, one God in three persons, even though the concept is hard to understand in my human mind. When I pray to God the Father, to Jesus my Savior, and to the Holy Spirit individually. Since God is all in one, am I doing wrong? If I pray to the Father, am I praying to all? This may seem silly, but it's something I really wonder about.
Well, I really think that when Jesus was baptized, the Son went into the water, and a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved Son in whom I'm well pleased. And a dove, the Holy Spirit, came and sat on him. So you've got the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit all together. They're three different people, but they function together as one. And it's hard to say, for example, but you reflect light, and you can get purple, and you can get orange and so forth out of one light beam. So the Trinity is one, but if you want to pray, you pray to the Father. Supposedly, you pray to the Father in the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus, but God isn't a Philadelphia lawyer. He's not trying to, it's your heart with Him. You're talking to a Father in love, and He understands what's in your heart. All right?
Amen. All right, Narok says, my friend's wife is cheating on him. Mutual friends tell me that she has dalliances with other women. She sends love messages to women on social media, married ones too. Should I tell my friend about his wife? He's oblivious to all of this. Everyone is keeping him in the dark. They have young children together, and I don't want to see their marriage ruined.
He'll hate you if you tell him. He'll blame you. They'll blame the messenger, not the message. He'll be devastated, and he will cast you in the role of villain. If you really want to help him, there must be some subtle way. If this woman is messing around on Facebook, surely you could get a tweet or something that would bring, before your friend in a subtle sort of way that maybe he doesn't even know who's doing it. And his eyes would be open. It's a tragic thing to be married. She's apparently is a lesbian and is having affairs with married women.
Yeah.
So she's trying to break up somebody else's marriage. She sounds like a terrible person. But being the messenger of that bad news is not going to help you very much, so I'd count the cost. You'll lose your friend. You might help him, but he might come out of this thing devastated. I imagine he's going to be, but he needs to be warned somewhere along the way. That's a horrible thing to have happen.
All it's right. kind of tricky, because I think if I had a good friend, I'd want to know, but then, like you said...
You hate the messenger. Invariably, you'll attribute to him the problem. All right.
Well, those were excellent answers.
Well, thank you so much. It's good to be with you.
You too, and great questions. Thanks for writing in.